Hi guys, welcome to this plumberparts.co.uk video all about expansion vessels on potable hot water systems, and in particular this lovely new GWS expansion vessel that we're going to fit today. Before we continue, can you please subscribe to our channel by clicking on the link that's appearing right now? Thank you very much, we do lots of fun videos. Also, there's going to be a competition in this video to win an Apple Watch. How about that? We'll tell you how to enter that competition later on. Anyway, for now, let's have a look at this lovely video about potable water expansion vessels and in particular, Global Water Solutions' new product. Have fun guys, and I'll see you soon. Hold tight!
Plumberparts.co.uk, home of Find Your Plumber.
Hi guys, thanks for popping along to watch this video. It's a little bit of a niche one for today. We're going to be looking at potable water expansion vessels. Now these are the white bulbous things we've got up here that take the expansion and contraction of our hot water as it heats up and down, ready to go out to our taps. Now the one we've got behind us here has gone wrong and we need to change it. Now I wanted to change it over for a different product, a new one that's just come out from a company called Global Water Solutions, or GWS, and they've made a product that I think as plumbers you guys are going to absolutely love, and you're going to see straight away why I prefer to fit these particular products. But firstly, let's have a quick look at what potable water expansion vessels do. So coming up here on this pipe just here, we've got our cold inlet in, okay? And straight away it goes through a combination valve just here. And then after that, we're off to an area where the cold water is going to be heated and cooled. Now, as we've said before, as cold water gets hot and cold, the molecules and particles in there start to vibrate and the body of the water gets larger. Now, we need somewhere to accommodate the expansion of that water. And the perfect place to do that is inside a GWS expansion vessel. This is mainly used on kind of anti-hammer devices or under-sink water heaters, but it's had some cutouts on it, so I'm going to be able to show you exactly how this system works. So imagine our cold water that's about to be heated is coming in on this pipe here. We then have a thick butyl diaphragm, and you're only going to get ones this thick on the GWS potable water expansion vessels. And then on this side here, we've got our pressurised air. As we know, air is a lot easier to compress, so we can leave a compressed amount of air in there, but water's not so easy to compress, and a heating system will especially struggle to do that, and you could end up with problems with certain components on the heating system. So what we do is we have our cold water coming in here, and as that gets warm, it can push onto this butyl diaphragm, which separates the air from the water, and any expansion that happens on the hot water side as this cold water is heated up is taken into this expansion vessel here, okay? Another great thing about this little expansion vessel that we've got here is it's going to show us why GWS expansion vessel is kind of better than the other ones. The first thing I notice is actually how sturdy they are. These are really, really well made. The actual metal fabrication of these is very, very thick, very strong, very sturdy. The rubber membrane, okay, it's not just a standard rubber membrane. This is a butyl membrane. They've got a really good plastic liner on the inside of here to protect the expansion vessel as it goes in and out. It just feels like really good quality stuff. Now, most of the other expansion vessels in the trade don't use butyl rubber, and non-butyl membranes straight away start to permeate between the air and the water and over time fail. These boys do not fail. There's a 5-year warranty on these, okay? So they back up how well they're made. And it comes down to small things as well. Like when you take the Schrader end off, you'll notice straight away that the Schrader cap is made of brass and also has a small little rubber O-ring in there to stop any leaks coming out of the Schrader valve as well. So to recap, why do we use expansion vessels on potable water systems? Well, first and foremost, it is safely to absorb the expansion of water as it's being heated into this thermal store here. It's also to make sure that the fixtures of the heating system run smoothly. You've got a nice air cushion there, so it means that there's no water hammer or anything like that. Also, it means that dangerous pressures won't go up in the heating system, which means that pressure relief valves will not be triggered and potential safety hazards are reduced. All of these factors are helped out by just installing a GWS expansion tank, so all the fittings and fixtures go down to mean that these are completely maintenance free. And there's a few things I just want to point out on it that I think most seasoned plumbers are going to absolutely love. Number one, I mean, it's got standard 3/4 BSP male outlet thread on there. That's completely normal for all expansion types. Number two, it is just built to last. It really is. These are strong. Number three, something that no one seems to think about until GWS have just made this, is the fact that there's a bracket that's built onto this. This means that this can be fitted on the wall or on the floor completely fine. On this job here, we're going to fit it on the floor. But silly little things like they've got nice wide feet on it, so you can actually get down past the side of the expansion body to do the screws up. The amount of times you can't do that on normal expansion vessels. Also, they've got, yet again, really good Schrader connector just around here. with that brass inlet on there as well. So just the quality of the product overall, I'm really happy to recommend that you fit one of these if you've got any problems, or if you're installing a new unvented cylinder, definitely whack one of these on, okay, because it's going to make sure that you're not going to get any problems on the heating system as well. So you've seen how important it is to have a potable water expansion vessel on the heating system. It's a legal requirement. And you've also seen how good the GWS expansion vessel is and why I fit them all the time. Now, let's have a quick look at the job we're going to do here. We're going to remove this old expansion vessel here that's failed on the wall up there like so. We're also going to remove the braided hose as well. And we're going to pipe our expansion vessel using the floor mounted system that we've got here up in hard copper. So rather than you guys watching us do that all the way, we'll speed it up for you so the process is even quicker. Guys, there we go, nice little quick install, just a little bit of 22mm soldering, had a little bit of a run on one of the pipes. Oh, it happens to the best of us. But you can see how easy it is to install one of these. We've got it lovely, sturdily sat down here now, no problems whatsoever. There's a couple of other points I'd like to quickly cover about popping a larger kind of expansion vessel on a system like this. For a start, it means that we've also got an extra accumulation of cold water to inject into the system as well. So that kind of means that you've got slightly higher pressure, or at least a more volume of water than you would have had on the old system if you're upgrading the size of the expansion vessel. And also, obviously, we've got more air cushion here for us to go into as well. So basically, it just means we've got better flow, kind of better pressure, and also because of the components on here as well, with everything on here, I know it's going to be reliable as well. So if we have a quick look at how this system now works, earlier on we had the problem because our expansion vessel up here has failed. We're going to rip that off the wall in a minute. It's completely redundant and not piped in, so we had no expansion. Heating components like this are not designed to take that expansion. If they don't have a pressure relief valve that works properly on them, these can split and cause a huge amount of damage to your house. So what we've done, we've now put a new expansion vessel on here, the GWS just down here. It's miles more reliable. It comes out of our combination valve just down here like so. So any of the water when this is getting heated up will come out of here, pop down our pipe into here, and then straight into our expansion vessel like that. That means our pressures stay stable. We're not going to risk the failure of a high pressure relief valve opening up and then leaks happening, or any problems with the components of the heating system. Just see these as a nice cushion for the whole system and make sure that none of the components in the system get hurt or anything like that. There's no water hammer, but also improves the pressure and obviously improves the safety of the system no end. So to recap, none of these beasts are going to leak their air. They've got 5-year warranty on them. Sort of speaks for itself, doesn't it? And you're not going to have to worry about any problems with failures of components on the system. There's also a competition to win an Apple Watch. You've also got a chance to win one of 20 plumber parts and GWS stickers. Number one, find this post on our Twitter account, follow and retweet us, okay? Just do that and you've entered. Or find this post on our Facebook account, follow and share that post. You'll find links to our Twitter and our Facebook accounts in the description below this video. Click on that and do that. Once you've done that, we're going to select 20 lucky people to win a plumber parts sticker and also a GWS sticker. Once we've chosen the 20 people and they've got their stickers, all they need to do is take a photo of them with their stickers stuck in pride of place and send that over to us at our Twitter, or send that over to us at our Facebook. We will then choose our favorite picture, okay, with you guys with our plumber parts and the GWS sticker, and our favorite picture from all of those will be the lucky winner of the Apple Watch. So it's a few steps to go through, but I think it's going to be great fun. And let's face it, you've been lucky enough to learn a little bit about potable water expansion vessels here. How about entering a little competition as well? So thanks ever so much for watching, guys. Please do subscribe to us by clicking on the link that's appearing right now, or in the links in the video description below. Anyway, I'll see you in our next video. Thanks ever so much for watching, and do remember, everyone, to hold tight. See you soon.